Welcome to class 18 of business environment. Today we are going to deal with limitations of state intervention in business. So first is red tapism. So what happens in red tapism? So we are going to get delay in the permission, getting license, etc. So why? So state intervention in business. So how does the government is going to interfere in business? So that is by enacting the law, passing the legislation. Okay, and whatever laws, what is these laws prescribes, how the business should establish, or so the law is going to prescribe in what formalities, in what procedure the business should fulfill to get its establishment. So, and these things is been monitored by what? Monitored by the government machineries. So what happens here? Government machineries may take unreasonable time. So simply, so unnecessarily what they do, they are going to make delay in giving the permission, make delay in granting the license. So files will be not cleared quickly, so which results in unreasonable delay. So the red tapism says you are not going to get the permission very quickly, or you have to follow various formalities. So in order to establish your business, it will take much delay. So the next is corruption. So your corrupt practices are harmful for the growth of business and development of society. So we know that. So when there is corruption, it is not a good practice and it will be very harmful for the business and the societal growth. So what happens here? Power is in the hand of politics. Okay, political people, politicians. So there are more regulation. If there are more regulation, there will be more power in the hands of people. So to sanction permit, to give you the license, to clear the files, so they are going to charge something. So they are going to charge something, and that is in the form of corruption. So what happens now? If you are going to undergo, or when the corruption is there, it is not a good practice, right? And it will harm the growth of business and development of society. The next is lack of initiative. So lack of initiative means when there are more restrictions. So normally the business should be more innovative. So business people who take an initiative can achieve success. So when they will get the success? Only when they are innovative and when they have a freedom to start their own enterprise of their choice. Okay, so what happens here? Many restrictions or which are imposed by the state, so that will make a hurdle for innovative things or lack of initiative. So innovativeness and initiative can grow when there is a freedom to think and act on the business idea. So state intervention is going to bring more restrictions through laws, procedures. So business initiative is lost due to the procedural hurdles. The next is manipulation of laws and planning. So you may heard about lobby. Okay, you may heard about lobby. The pressure of some lobby may influence government and the administration to manipulate policies and laws to suit a vested interest in society. So what is this lobby? Pressure of some lobby, we say. So lobby means the big industrialist, the traders who are there. So such lobby may influence the government to change the policies and laws that suits for their requirement. So who are the lawmakers now? So lawmakers and policymakers in the economy is the politicians and the top bureaucrats, right? So these people is going to frame, they are going to frame the policies, so that should be for the benefit of the business and for the entire society. So sometimes these people, the lobbies who are there, the industrialists and the traders, so due to them, their pressure, so the policies and the laws will be manipulated. The next is lack of coordination. So where there is lack of coordination, so government is going to pass many legislation. Government have too many departments, and each department, each agency will have different rules and regulations. Okay, so for example, one is going to pass the, or we can say one is going to give you the permission and you have to report it to the various government agencies to conduct the business. And each department has its own regulations, rules and conditions. So there may not be proper coordination between these agencies. So unless a person gets permission from all this government establishment, he cannot start the business. So each department has its own rules and regulations. To follow all these rules and regulations, so there will be much delay and it is not convenient for the business. The next is wastage of resources. Wastage of resources. How the resources will be wasted here? The state will decide the priority of industries where the resources are to be invested. So which means, so the priority or the areas or where the business chosen by the government is, so like backward areas, so adequate, where there is no adequate business facilities. So in such areas you are going to start your business or industries. So what happens? So you may not get a good demand for your product. Okay, so they may be based on the populist or the political consideration. The market may not accept the products of such industry. So continuously if this takes place, so it will result in wastage of resources invest in those business. The next is poor planning. So we know government officers are going to plan. So they are the administrator, no doubt in that, but they are not the expert planner, right? So they are not the expert planner. So planning machinery and its implementation is in the hands of the government officers. So these people may not be the well economic or a good planner. Okay, so they are just the administrator. So what can we conclude with this? So conclusion says that state intervention is necessary, but the intervention must satisfy economic objective of business and meet social goals of the society. So it is mistyped here, social goals of society. So the level and extent of state intervention must be democratic. So what is democratic? Democratic means it should not be forced. So whatever rules and regulations you are going to make, it should benefit the majority of people. The next, it said it should be efficient. So how it can be efficient? So when you are people in charge, so who are the people in charge? So they must be qualified and they should know how to make the policies and pass the regulation for the benefit of society and business. So it should be simple and adaptable. So whatever legislation passed for the intervention, so that must be very simple. So rules, procedures should not be rigorous. Okay, so it may result in delay and give the scope for corruption. So it should be very simple. Then the next is large interest. Large interest means the policies of the government must be introduced to ensure the welfare of large section of population. Thank you.